Men of the 24th Infantry. This is Texas. And we have a great opportunity here. A legacy, if proven worthy, will carry us all the way to the shores of France.
Yeah! This is a historic film. Tell us a little bit about what it's about and how you think it will resonate with contemporary audiences.
I wrote the original script a long time ago, and it's about the Houston riot of 1917. And when I saw this photograph, it said the largest murder trial in American history. And I had never heard anything about it. I'm kind of a history geek. I never heard anything about it. And I was just fascinated, researched it, and really kind of found this amazing story. And so I hope it will really speak to people today. I mean, obviously, in the wake of George Floyd's murder, I think it's a reminder that this has been going on a long time. You know, 103 years ago, this incident happened. And it just lets you know that one bad policeman, you know, 103 years ago could destroy a community and rock a nation just like one did this year.
I don't think I've talked to you personally since you won the Oscar for being a co-screenwriter for The Black Klansman. And I want to find out from you, how has that changed your life? And where were you in the process of getting this film done when you actually won the award?
I actually wrote this with Trey Byers. We kind of rewrote my original script while I was working on Black Klansman. And when Black Klansman happened and we won the award, the script was finished. And so we kind of leveraged that to make this film. Originally, my agent, when I wrote it a long time ago, my agent said, no one will ever make this film. And I think it's a testament that things have improved some. I think America is kind of ready for this movie now, I'd like to believe. I think America can understand this movie a lot more now than maybe it could a few years ago.
When I aim the gun, I saw a man. He didn't see one back.
I'm Russ Simmons and
Sean Edwards, Fox 4 News.